Hi, my name's Jane Muhich, and I'm one of your statistics instructors. And today we're going to talk about conditional probability and the general addition rule for probabilities. But one of the main goals of this video here today is to focus on getting the correct notation and writing up problems neatly and correctly. So we're going to do four problems with one context, and the context is an employment data at a large company reveal that 72% of the workers are married. So 72% of the workers are married, that 44% are college graduates, and that half of the college graduates are married. So find the following probabilities. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to declare my variables. I'm going to declare what events are happening and then use that in my notation. So we've really got two main ideas here, two events, like either employees are married and or they're college graduates. So I'm going to declare my variables. I think I'm going to declare them over here, and I can just leave them throughout my different problems. So I'm going to let M equals an employee is married. And I'm going to let G equal an employee as a college graduate. Okay. And so also looking and noticing that I'm defining the event, I'm not defining the probability. So I'm going to go and look and see what I have and write down what's given. So I have that 70%, 72% are married. So that means the probability that someone is married is 72%, but we're really going to usually write that as a decimal. The probability that an employee is a college graduate, so the probability of G is 0.44. And then my last bit of info, that 44% of the college graduates, about half of those are married. So half of the 44% are both college graduates and married. Everyone, right? So that means, well, half. So if they're married and a college graduate both, that would be half of the 44%. Or 22%. So that's what I'm given in my problem. So the first probability I'm going to find today is the probability that an employee is married or a college graduate. So remember that or means you could be this or that or both. So we're going to use our general probability formula with this particular context. So we're looking for the probability, remember that or would be married or using that union symbol, right? Or is the same as union. Using that union symbol, so married or a college graduate. So then from section 3.8, we're going to add those probabilities together. But I've counted the probability that I, of the married college graduates twice, so I'm going to have to subtract that out once. So I've got the probability that the employee is married, I've got the probability that the employee is a college graduate, but then in both of those included the overlap of the married college graduates, so to just count them once in each of those two times, I'm going to take out one of them. And then I have all these quantities in the ones that I'm given, so I'm going to happily just plug them in. And noticing here that when I'm drawing, when I'm writing out this formula, I'm plugging into these individual quantities. My equal signs are lined up as I go down. And so now just plugging into the various quantities with what I was given. So the married employees were 72%. The college graduates were 44%. And the overlap, the married college graduates, were 22%, taking out that once, taking out the overlap. And I figured this out at home. And I got 94%. Okay, so now we're on to part B of our probability problem. So in part B, we're going to look at a married employee. What's the probability a married employee is a college grad? So in this particular problem, we're already only looking at married employees. So out of the married employees we have, on the condition that the employee is married, what's the probability they're a college grad? Or how it is in our WAMAP, what is the probability that somebody is a college grad given that they're married? So this is a conditional probability. We're only looking at the subset of employees that are married. So we're going to use a conditional probability formula, and we've already defined our variables, so we're going to use those same variables. So using our notation for a conditional probability, what's the probability that the employee is a college grad given that they're married? And then I'm going to take the variables that I have, and I'm going to plug into the conditional probability formula. So in the numerator, I'd have the probability that the employee is a college grad and married, the intersection of those. And then in the bottom, I'd have, well, it's out of the probability that the employee is married. So already looking at only the subset of married employees. So I'm just going to plug into that formula now, and I don't have to do much because these quantities were given in the original problem. So the probability that the employee is married in the denominator was 72%. And then I had the intersection given, that the probability that the employee was married and a college graduate was 22. That would go in my numerator. And I would carry that out, which I did already. And you know, if you're carrying out and approximating, it's always good to use the approximation symbol, the wavy equals. And so I'd have 0.3056. So that's rounded to the nearest 10,000th or four decimal places, which is very common in our class. And if I was going to write this as a percentage, which then is kind of easier to see how much that really would be, that would be approximately, usually rounding percentages to the nearest tenth. So there's the probability, it's a 30.6% chance that the employee is, that out of the married employees, that the employee is a college graduate. Okay, so we're going on to our third part of our problem. And so in this particular question, we're going to determine the probability that an employee is neither married nor a college grad. So neither married nor a college grad is really a union similar to an or. It's just that they're not the union of not being either one of those things. So since in this particular problem, we weren't given the probability of not being those things in our initial information in the problem, I kind of thought it might be easiest if we built a contingency table with this information, and then we could just read some of that off of the contingency table. So I'm going to start putting that together. And so again, we have our two conditions. We have that someone is a college grad, and remember we labeled that G, and then not a college grad, that would be the complement of the being a college grad. So we're going to use the complement symbol of having that little G on the top. So that complement means they're not a college grad. And then we'd have married. We labeled that with an M earlier. We declared that variable. And then not married would be the complement of being married. So that would be M with a little, whoopsie, a little C at the top. Not too bad. Okay, so I'm going to fill in what I had. So the probability that somebody was married included all the college grads and not a college grad. So that would be over here in the total column. And the probability of being a grad was 44%. And then we were given the intersection of how the probability that somebody was married and a college grad was 22. And then they told us that half of those people who were married weren't college grads. So that would be 22 as well. And then I know that I want all my probabilities to really add up to 1. So I'm just going to fill in. I'd have 50. And then to make 1 on this side, I'd have to have, doing a little mental math, I'd have 0.28. So I'd have a 0.06 to get 0.22 plus 0.06 equals 0.28. And then I'd have 0.50 plus 0.06 would be 0.56. And then just checking that I haven't made some sort of error, which I can make, those two, 0.44 and 0.56, add up to 1. So everything checks out. Okay, so now I can get, I can go about solving the problem. And I'm going to solve it right down here. So an employee, if I was using probability notation, which is one of the things that we're making these videos for, so you want to pay attention to it, we're really looking for the probability that an employee, right, is neither married, so they're not married, or they're not a college grad. So we could go about and use our general probability rule for addition. We're really looking at the probability that the person isn't married plus the probability that they're not a college grad minus taking out that overlap of the not married people who aren't college grads once, because we've added that in twice. So I'm just going to substitute those quantities in from my table. So not married would be 0.28, right? Would be at the end of this row. Not a college grad would be the total of the not a college grad column, right? 0.56. Minusing the intersection of the not married, not college grads would be 0.06. And calculating that, which I did already, would be 0.78. Okay, we're on to our last example here. And so we're going to determine the probability that employee who didn't graduate college isn't married. So an employee who didn't graduate college, isn't married, isn't the same as the intersection of the non-married, non-college graduates. Again, we're looking at the subset of the employees who didn't graduate college first. On the condition they didn't graduate college, what's the probability that they're not married? So it's a conditional probability again, except we're looking at these complements, so we want to keep that notation in mind. Okay, so I'm going to do my problem down here. So I'm looking at, take one more moment to give it a read. So the employees who didn't graduate college isn't married. An employee who didn't graduate college isn't married. So on the condition that they didn't graduate college, what's the probability that they're not married? Or given the employee didn't graduate college, what's the probability they aren't married. So my condition is they didn't graduate college, and I'm looking out of that subgroup, what's the probability they're not married? And then I'm going to plug in my conditional probability formula, and I'm going to plug into those quantities. So I'm looking for the probability that an employee is not married and not a college graduate over the probability that they're not a college graduate. So usually, if I was writing this on paper, but I'm writing on this crazy glass screen, I'd continue and plug in below in a vertical organization with my equal signs lined up, but I don't really have room here. But if I was writing on paper, I would. So I'm going to look for the intersection that the employee isn't married and isn't a college graduate, which we found in our last example, and then the probability that the employee is not a college graduate, which is 0.56. And I would do that calculation. I'm going to carry it out to four decimal places again, because that is pretty much standard in this course. But then if I was going to round it to the nearest percent, I'd really round it to the nearest tenth of a percent. Always good to have one place of accuracy. So that's approximately 10.7% that an employee who didn't graduate college isn't married.